Shalom, brothers and sisters. And once again, this is Shabar Judah Israel bringing you another lesson concerning Solid Foundation Israelite Academy. Okay, we're going to give you lesson on top of lesson, brothers and sisters, and we're going to keep pushing this truth and sincerity through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bahashimamah Yahweh Shai. And on tonight, it's going to be a short lesson, but we need to deal with something concerning Genesis chapter 6. On the behalf of supposedly what a lot of brothers and sisters would speak of, fallen angels. That's not true. There are no such thing as fallen angels coming down to earth and having sexual affairs with women. And after this lesson, I hope you would be edified enough to see that. Because this dies hard among you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Okay? This fallen angel BS, this came out the Christian community. Okay? We're going to start off with a verse, brothers and sisters. Let's start off with a verse before we get into it. Double honors to those elders and apostles. Salutations to those brothers. And all praises and glorification and due honor is to Yahweh, Bahashem, Hamashiach Yahweh Shai, Yeshua Shalom. So we're going to get into it, brothers and sisters, to show you, according to Genesis chapter 6, there were no fallen angels literally coming to earth and having sexual affairs with the daughters of man. Okay, that is bull. Okay, so let's get into it. This is John 3 and 1. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. So Nicodemus was a Jew, man. An Israelite, a black man. He was from the same tribe as Yahweh Shai, that most classifies Jesus today. They were both Jews. Nicodemus was a Pharisee. Now, who were the Pharisees? They were the leaders during that time. They were the leaders of the Jews, so to speak. Like, they would be like, supposedly, modern day pastors today supposed to be leaders of the Jews, but these pastors are corrupt today. They are not teaching us the actual truth according to these scriptures. These pastors today are teaching us lies. But I'm just letting you know, Pharisees back in Yahweh Shai time would be labeled as modern day pastors today, and Nicodemus was one of them. He was a Pharisee. So John 3 and 2, it says that the same came to Yahweh Shai by night, because he couldn't do it by day, okay? Afraid that someone may see him and sell him out, he came to Yahweh Shai by night and said unto him, Rabbi, which is teacher, we know that thou art a teacher come from God. For no man can do these miracles that thou dost except God be with him. So Nicodemus knew that Yahweh Shai was serious. He already knew Yahweh Shai was the son of the living power, man. But he had a couple questions he had to ask Yahweh Shai. Let's get into it. John 3 and 3. Yahweh Shai answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except the man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. So Yahweh Shai tells Nicodemus, you have to be born again. John 3 and 4. Nicodemus said unto him, How can a man be born when he's old? How can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? This wasn't a physical birth here. This is a spiritual birth. You have to be born spiritually. You have to be reborn spiritually. Nicodemus did not comprehend that you had to be reborn spiritually. He thought it was of a physical birth, man. That's why he asked that question. How can a man enter to a second time into his mother's womb and be born? John 3 and 5, Yahweh Shai answered and said, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except the man be born again of water and of spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. So I'm going to stop there, because the reason why I brought that out, okay, pursuing Genesis chapter 6, because a lot of you brothers like to say Genesis chapter 6 is on the behalf of fallen angels. Well, guess what? You have to be born again, just like Yahweh Shai tells Nicodemus, because you can't bring this Christian residue in the truth, man. Okay? These Christian aspects, these Christian trademarks, you can't bring that into the world of the truth. When you're born again, you have to leave that garbage outside. You can't bring that into the world of the truth. When you realize so-called black man, black woman, and children, when you realize that you are the true Jews and you are the Israelites from the tribe of Judah, and that Christ was a black man, okay, and that God is black, and all the other prophets are black, and the white man is the damn devil that the Bible speaks of. When you come into the truth, you have to leave all those Christian residuals out, man, because guess what? You need, being born again is 100% being born again. A lot of brothers and sisters have tried to bring that Christian residue within Genesis chapter 6 and still support this fallen angel doctrine. I have made several videos addressing that Genesis chapter 6 is not talking about fallen angels. So after this, hopefully, I will nip this in the bud and I won't have to review Genesis chapter 6 again to edify you brothers and sisters. Genesis chapter 6 verse 1. And it came to pass when men began to multiply on the face of the earth, and the daughters were born unto them. So it said men. This talking about all nationality of people. You must realize in the beginning of time, there were nations, but they were not addressed as nations in the beginning of time. They were sectioned off. They were just like, it was three subdivisions. They were sectioned into three categories of man. You had that righteous seed that was known as sons of God in the beginning. You had the modern day Gentile nations that were known as sons of man in the beginning. And then you had the last classification of man. You had the sons of the wicked, which is the so-called white man today. So it was three subdivisions of man classified in the ancient world. Sons of God, who are modern day Israelites, sons of man, who are modern day heathens and Gentiles, and sons of the wicked, who are modern day so-called white man, white people, which is the devil the Bible speaks of. So Genesis 6 and 2 says, the sons of God saw the daughters of men, that they were fair, and they took them wives of all which they chose. That's basically talking about interracial marriage, man, interracial sexual affairs. That's what Genesis chapter 6 is talking about. Genesis chapter 6 is the first time interracial marriages took place in the Bible. That's what it's talking about in a metaphorical way. The sons of God, being the Israelites, took the daughters of man, took daughters of other nations that wasn't another chosen, that wasn't another righteous lineage, and they married those heathen women back then. The sons of God, that righteous lineage, the sons of God. They saw the daughters of man that they were fair. They saw these beautiful heathen women that they were fair to look upon, and they took them wives of all which they chose. That's called interracial marriage. This is spoken of many times in the Bible. And I'm going to show you that Genesis chapter 6 is not talking about fallen angels. Okay? Brothers and sisters, wait the hell up. Most of you don't even understand these scriptures. But all peace and blessings be upon the ones that can understand the scriptures. Angels don't have sex at all, brothers and sisters. There's no need for angels to procreate because angels is infinite power. An angel is pure energy. An angel doesn't have cunning devised concepts. Angels are not capable of having sex with terrestrial beings on the earth, man. That's total nonsense. Let's go to the next verse. Matthew 22. Matthew 22 and 29. And this is what it reads. Yehoshaphat answered and said unto them, ye do err, not knowing the scriptures nor the power of God. Who did he tell these? Who did he make that statement to? Who did Yehoshaphat make that statement to? Yehoshaphat made that statement to these Sadducees, man. Right here, Matthew 22, 23. The same day came to him Sadducees, which would be like modern day pastors today as well. The Sadducees believed that there was no such thing as resurrection. The Sadducees during that time didn't believe in reincarnation, or some may say regeneration. So they asked Yehoshaphat, the son of God, saying, Master Moses said, if a man die having no children, his brother shall marry his wife and raise up seed unto his brother. Because that was a law That was dealing with that was a law during the ancient world. If your brother didn't leave behind seed, you had to take upon your brother's spouse, and you were to leave seed behind for your brother, that his name would be not blotted out of Israel. That was a custom. That was a law, man, back in the ancient world. Okay, Matthew 22:5. Now there were with us seven brethren. And the first, when he had married a wife, deceased, having no issue, he left his wife unto his brother. And likewise, the second also, and the third unto the seventh. So these there was one particular brother that he had a wife, but he didn't leave behind seed. So after he died, his brother took the woman, didn't leave behind seed. After he died, his brother took the woman, didn't leave behind seed. Till it got all the way through the seven brothers. And last but not least, Matthew 22:27 tells you that the woman died also. Matthew 22:28. Therefore, in the resurrection, they was being sarcastic. They was being facetious with Yahawashi. Basically, primarily, so to speak. In other words, since you believe in a damn resurrection, or you believe that people live more than once, they were saying, in the so-called resurrection, whose wife shall she be of the seven brothers, for they all had her. They thought they had Yahawashi hemmed up on this question. Yahawashi told those Sadducees that you err. You don't know a damn thing about the scriptures nor the power of God. And a lot of you brothers and sisters out there, you err. Especially GOCC. I'm calling you out, man. I'm calling out the whole damn camp. If you still preaching that fallen angel bullshit, you in err. You not know the scriptures, man. If you still believing in that, recall, elder lawyer, anybody who teaching that nonsense is in error. That's why some of you niggas had to be destroyed. Because guess what? The leaders caused the people to err. Let me show you that. This is Isaiah 9:16, for the leaders of this people cause them to err, and they that are led of them are destroyed. All you Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans that are following these false leaders, your soul is destroyed already, man. Because why? These leaders that have been set up in certain camps cause a lot of brothers and sisters to err. Okay. GOCC being one of them. This camp is so far off. Damn, man. I was once part of GOCC. The water Yahweh by Shemamah Yahweh side, you put the spirit of truth on my heart to come out that damn camp, man. Yahweh said a lot of people err, not knowing the scriptures, because if you knew the scriptures, you would know that fallen angels, there was no such thing, and you would know that angels are not capable of procreation or having sex or any sexual affairs, period. Let's see, Matthew 22:30. For in the resurrection they neither marry nor are given in marriage, but they are as the angels of God in heaven. Yahweh told those Sadducees in the resurrection, man. In the spirit world, they neither marry, man, nor are given in marriage. What is marriage? Sex. A sexual bond. That's what marriage is, pursuing the scriptures. Real Hebrews know that. According to the Bible, sex is marriage, man. Let me show you that. Man, we got to get it together, man. This is, let's see, this is Exodus 22:16. If a man entice a maid that is not betrothed, meaning not engaged, she hasn't been fiddled with, no man has been engaged to her, she's solitary, she's single. If she's not betrothed, not engaged, not in a relationship, if a man basically meet this maid and it's okay, she's not betrothed, and lie with her, what is that? That's sex, man. And lie with her, he shall surely endow her to be his wife, because that's what marriage is, to lie with, man. Sexual bondage. He shall surely endow her to be his wife. That's what marriage is, sex, man. Look at marriage in the Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary, and it tells you marriage is a personal, I believe, agreement or something like that. Let me get that, brothers and sisters, right quick. Let me show you that. We're going to marriage in the Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary. I know you can't see it, but I'm going to read it aloud, brothers and sisters. This is page 345 in the Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary. You can purchase this book online, very little nothing. Okay, it says marriage is an intimate personal union to which a man and a woman consent, consummated, and continuously nourished by sexual intercourse and perfected in a lifelong partnership of mutual love and commitment. So marriage is an intimate personal union. It's intimate and it's personal. It's a personal union to which a man and a woman consent. What is that personal union? That man and woman consent. Sex, man. Okay? So marriage is sex. All right? And pursuing to Exodus 22 and 16. If a man lie with a woman, she ought to be his wife only if she not betrothed. So sex is marriage in the Bible. All right? Now, when we go back to the account on Yahawashi, let's go back. All right. That's why he told those Sadducees, you err. He said, not knowing the scriptures, for in the resurrection, they neither marry. They neither have sex. Angels don't have sex. They don't need to procreate or produce anything. Why? I mean, just think about it. Why in the hell would an angel need to procreate for? The only reason why men and women come together in personal union and procreate and have sexual affairs on the earth and have children, the reason why men and women do that, because we don't live forever on this terrestrial plane. So we have to leave behind seed, man. Okay? That's how we remain forever on earth, by leaving behind seed, by leaving behind generations of people. That's why we have to procreate, because we get old up in age and we die out. So we procreate, we reproduce, we replenish the earth, okay? We leave seed behind, because one day these bodies get old and they die out, man. But angels, they don't need to procreate, because they are infinite power, man. Star bodies, infinite power, pure energy. They don't need no reason to procreate. Yahweh shall say they neither marry nor are given in marriage, but they are as the angels of God in heaven, because that's all a spirit is when it evacuates the body. Once a spirit evacuates the body, automatically by default, it becomes an angel, man. We are all angels trapped in the flesh, man. We are angels that's trapped in the flesh. We trapped in these chains of darkness, man. So we are nothing but angelic beings trapped in carnal flesh, man. And once the flesh deteriorates, once it dies out, the spirit releases itself, becoming that full angelic potential star body again, man, pure energy. So we don't need to procreate in our angelic form, because we're infinite power. The only time we need to procreate is when we be incarnated and put into a body, man, because these bodies grow old and die. The word body comes from the Latin word bodig, which means house. So this body is a house for the spirit to dwell upon, man. Once the spirit leaves the body, the spirit becomes pure energy. So it don't need no damn reason to procreate and have sex. Okay? Now, we're going to close out with this, brothers and sisters. We need to understand Genesis chapter 6 and what was going on. I told you earlier in Genesis chapter 6, what is going on is interracial marriage, man. The sons of God, that chosen righteous lineage, going outside of their holy lineage and sleeping with other women that was not of that godly bloodline. That's all it's talking about. How do we know that? We're going to back up a little bit, and we're going to show you where that person that the godly bloodline came to, that person that the Israelite nation today would come out of in the beginning of time. So we're going to back up in Genesis, all right? And we're going to look at Genesis chapter 4, verse 25. Genesis 4:25. And Adam knew his wife again, and she bare a son, and called his name Seth. Now Seth means appointed. For God said she had a. For God said she. Who is this? Who is talking? Eve. For God said she, Eve, have appointed me another seed instead of Abel, who Cain slew. So Cain kills his brother. His Cain, being the oldest, kills his brother Abel. And what did the Most High God do on Eve's behalf? He blessed Eve with another son in the place of Abel, which name was Seth. And she said, For God had appointed me another seed. So Seth means appointed. Now, what's another word for appointed? Because when you go into Seth,
Strong's H8352.
Shaith. 8352. And when you go down, it says self. It says compensation. Okay. The third son of Adam and Eve, also self. Now, when you look it up, also self means appointed. Now, what's a synonym for appointed? Chosen. What's another synonym for chosen? Elected. So self would be that appointed one. Self would be the appointed one. That holy bloodline would come from, okay? That the nation of Israel would come out of. But before they were called Israel, you got to understand, Jacob was not born during this time. So they were not called Israelites. They were called sons of God. So that appointed one, which was Seth, he would be that forerunner for that holy nation of people, which is Israel to come many years. He would be that holy one, that holy forefather that the holy bloodline will come from. All right. And anybody that came descended from self bloodline were not to marry sons of man, were not to marry other people, were not to marry outside their bloodline. All right. Now, a lot of people don't know this, but it's the truth. When you look at Genesis chapter 4. Genesis chapter 4 speaks about the bloodline of Cain, which were Cain is the wicked one. Genesis chapter 4 speaks of Cain. Now, when we go down to, let's say, Genesis 4 and 17, okay? Genesis 4 and 17 speaks about the wicked bloodline of Cain, man, who slew his brother Abel. Now, the sons of God, which came from Seth's bloodline, was not to cross over and take daughters from Cain's bloodline. Neither should Cain, wicked seed, his bloodline, take daughters of Seth's bloodline. It says, Cain knew his wife, she conceived, and bare Enoch. He built the city and called the name of the city after the name of his son, Enoch. Okay? So Cain was the wicked one. That would be the wicked bloodline that the sons of God, which came from Seth's bloodline, were not to cross over and have dealings and marriages with. We're going to show you. Don't worry about it. All right. We're going to show you. Brothers and sisters, this is 1 John. Three and 12 to show you that Cain is truly the wicked one, his bloodline. And the Cainites today are the Edomites, man. Actually, Cain was Esau in the reincarnation. Esau passed life with Cain, man. If you can receive that, brothers and sisters, a lot of you still sleep. But 1 John 3 and 10, in this, the children of God are manifest, and the children of the devil, whosoever does not righteousness is not of God, neither he that love not his brother. All this is in reference to Cain. The children of the devil, okay, whosoever do not do righteousness, okay, the people that is not of God, the people that neither show love to his brother, 1 John 3 and 11, for this is the message that you heard from the beginning. Now, Genesis means the beginning, man. that we should love one another. 1 John 3:12, it says, not as Cain, who was of that wicked one. So that's why I told you in the beginning of time, man, you had three categories of man before they was classified as nation. Sons of God, who would come out the righteous lineages of self-bloodline. Sons of man would be just other nations, and sons of the wicked would be the descendants of Cain, the daughters and the sons of Cain, the Cainites. Those were the wicked ones pursuing the 1 John 3:12. Cain was that wicked one who did what? Who slew his brother, man. Cain shed innocent blood, and the so-called white man doing that same damn thing today, man. It says, and wherefore he slew him because of his works were evil. Yeah, because the Cain, the children of Cain, is the Edomites today, and all their damn works are evil, man. Their works are nothing but pure evil. This is the epitome of evilness, so-called white man. And you were Cain in your past life in Genesis. And you slew your brother Abel, man. Okay? Cain and Abel in the past and the past was Esau and Jacob, man. Esau and Jacob in their past life were Cain and Abel, man. If you can receive that, brothers and sisters. Cain would be the wicked one. So when we go back to Genesis chapter 4, beginning with verse 17, it gives you a count of Cain's bloodline. They say Cain's first son was Enoch, right? And Enoch was born. Enoch had sons, Arad, and Arad begat Mahajiel. Mahajiel begat Methusiel. Methusiel begat Lamech. All these were evil seeds of Cain. It said, and Lamech took into him two wives. Now, the Bible never tells you about these two wives. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to give you an account on these two wives that Lamech took upon. Lamech, that evil-ass seed of Cain, the descendant of that wicked-ass bloodline of Cain, because that was Cain's descendant, Lamech, took two wives. The name of those was Adah, and the name of the other was Zillah. You're going to find out that Adah, right here, and Zillah, brothers and sisters, were not of Cain's bloodline right here. Adah and Zillah was of Seth's bloodline. So when the descendants of Cain, which was one of them being Lamech, which was the first polygamist in the earth, Lamech took upon two wives. Who these wives belonged to? The bloodline of Seth, man. So that was interracial marriage. That was crossing over into that wicked-ass bloodline of Cain. Adah and Zillah were Sethites. How do we know that? We're going to go to the book of Jasher and show you that, brothers and sisters. We're going into the book of Jasher. Now, brothers and sisters, those of you that don't believe the book of Jasher is part of the Bible, let me show you, first of all, the ancient book of Jasher. Those of you that don't believe this book was part of the Bible, please, these are reference verses that you can see for yourself. Joshua 10:13, 2 Samuel 1:18, and 2 Timothy 3:8. These are referred verses that tells you that the ancient book of Jasher was once in the Bible. These wicked ass scholars extracted the book, man. They extracted the book. We just gonna show you this account right here, Joshua 10:13. Okay. Joshua 10:13, and the sun stood still, and the moon stayed until the people had avenged themselves upon their enemies. Is this not written in the book of Jasher? And that's in your King James Bible. So the sun stood still in the midst of heaven and hasted not to go down about the whole day. So this was written in the book of Jasher, man. How come Jasher is not in the King James Bible? Because these wicked ass scholars extracted the book from the Bible, man. They extracted the book. Okay? Brothers and sisters, that's why I'm trying to show you that the ancient book of Jasher, these are the references that you can check out for yourself to see that this book was part of the Bible, man. The book of Jasher bridged the gap and tells you about a lot of gaps that's in Genesis. And we're going to deal thus with Revelation chapter 6 about the sons of God going into the daughters of man. Okay. Book of Jasher. So, we was mentioning in Genesis 4:19, Lamech, which was descendant from Cain, that wicked ass bloodline. Lamech was a wicked one too, because anybody that came from Cain bloodline, wicked by default. Wicked DNA people. That wicked man Lamech took two wives. These two wives were Ada and Zillah. How do we know that Ada and Zillah were the daughters of Seth? Well, first of all, brothers and sisters, Ada and Zillah were the daughters of Seth. Not the actual daughters of Seth, but the daughters that came out of Seth's bloodline. And I'm going to show you this. Right? Now, we got to go over Genesis chapter 5. They wasn't the actual daughters of Seth, Ada and Zillah, but they came from out of Seth's bloodline. They were Sethites, so to speak, descendants of Seth. So this is Genesis 5. All Lamech did was took two daughters of that righteous bloodline, and that was interracial marriage, man. This is the book of the generations of Adam. And then it go on and say, in the day that God created man in the likeness of God made he him. Now let's skip down. Genesis 5 and 3, Adam lived 130 years and begat a son in his own likeness. Okay, that is talking about righteousness, after his image, and called his name what? Seth. This was the third son of Adam and Eve. Seth replaced Abel because Cain slew Abel. So the Most High appointed another son in the place of Abel. That's what Seth means, appointed. Now this would be the chosen. This would be that child that that righteous bloodline would come out of, man. Anybody that came from out of Seth's bloodline was known as sons of God, because they was close to God back in the ancient world. We have separated ourselves far from God today, but we were so close to God back in the ancient world. The Sethites, the descendants of Seth, they were known as sons of God. And I'm going to show you that, brothers and sisters. I'm going to show you that. All right? This is Luke chapter 3. I'm going to show you that. Luke chapter 3, we'll go down. And we're going to begin with the generation of Yehoshua. We're going to go to Luke chapter 3, and we'll begin, let's say, somewhere around Luke 3 and 23 right here. I want to show you that. Luke 3 and 23. And Yehoshua himself began to be about 30 years of age, being, as was supposed, the son of Joseph, which was the son of Heli. Okay? Now, brothers and sisters, it gives the genealogy on Yahusha, who the world calls Jesus Christ. And it's starting with Yahusha and going all the way back to his ancient forefather. It says, which was the son of Matthias, which was the son of Levi, with the son of Melchi, and going all the way back down. It's going back down. It started from Yahusha, who the world knows as Christ, and it's going all the way back down to the ancient forefather, to show you what bloodline he came out of. Now, we're not going to read all these descendants, but we're going to keep going down just to show you the sons of God were the Sethites, man. Okay? Now, it goes all the way down. Yahusha genealogy going back to Adam. Luke 3 and 36, which was the son of Canaan, which was the son of Aphasdad, which was the son of Shem, that's Shem, which was the son of Noah, which was the son of Lamech, which was the son of Cain Lamech, that's Lamech on the righteous side, which was the son of Lamech, which was the son of Methuselah, which was the son of Enoch, which was the son of Jared, which was the son of Malaleel, which was the son of Canaan. Now you're going to find out that Ada and Zillah are Canaan daughters that wicked ass one of the Cain descendants took, which was Lamech, one of Cain descendants. One of the Cain descendants, the Cainites, took Ada and Zillah, which were Canaan right here, that righteous bloodline, two daughters. We'll get into that later. It says, which was the son of Enos, which was the son of Seth, which was the son of Seth. Now, Seth, that appointed one, which was the son of Adam, which was the son of God. Okay, so from Adam on out to Seth. Anybody that came afterwards were known as the sons of God. All these people that came out of Seth bloodline was known as the Sethites. Better yet, better known as the sons of God. They were called sons of God before they received the name Israel. And they took daughters of man who they chose, meaning that they went off and they slept with other people that was not within that righteous bloodline. That's all it's talking about. And like I say, from Adam to Seth to Enos to Canaan to Malaleel to Jared to Enoch to Methuselah, all this is recorded in Genesis chapter 5, man. All this is recorded in Genesis chapter 5, dealing with the generations of Adam, from Adam all the way down, from Adam to Seth, man, to Seth. Right here. Anybody that came out the self, anybody that came out of self bloodline was called sons of God, man. See, Enos, it says self. Enos, it goes down to Canaan. It goes down to, Genesis 5 and 10. Enos lived after he begat Canaan 815 years and begat sons and daughters. All the days of Enos were 905 years and he died. Canaan lived 70 years and begat Mahalalel. And Canaan lived after he begat Mahalalel 840 years. And what Canaan did, Canaan begat sons and daughters. Canaan begat sons and daughters. And Canaan's daughters were Ada and Zillah. Let's go back to Genesis 4. Now remember, Canaan came from Seth's bloodline, the righteous bloodline. It says in Genesis 5 and 13, Canaan begat sons and daughters. Let's focus on just Canaan daughters. Canaan daughters was Ada and Zillah. Remember we was bringing out in Genesis chapter 4, that Lamech, which was the descendant of Cain, a wicked-ass bloodline, took two wives. These two wives were known as Ada and Zillah. Now, Ada and Zillah was of that righteous bloodline. The Ada and Zillah was Canaan daughters. So can't you see right there? The wicked-ass Canaanites took the daughters and men from the righteous bloodline. And I'm going to show you that. We are now going into the book of Jasher to show you this. And it was 130 year. Let's kind of blow that up. Let's blow that up a little bit, brothers and sisters, so you can see that. This is the book of Jasher, chapter 2. All right. It says, and it was in the 130th year of the life of Adam upon the earth that he again knew Eve, his wife, as she conceived and bare a son in the likeness in his image. And she called his name what? Self. All right. Saying, because God has appointed me, self became the appointed one. Self became that appointed bloodline that the righteous would come from. Self was that appointed one that the nation of Israel would come out of in the long run. The nation of Israel is the chosen people in the Bible, the appointed ones, just like Seth was the appointed ones. So anyway, Eve said, because God has appointed me another seed in the place of Abel, for Cain has slain him. Now, we're not going to read all of Jasher chapter 2, but I'm going to show you this cross marriage in Genesis chapter 6 that I'm speaking about the sons of God to daughters of man. I'm going to show you this so you won't think it's no damn fallen angels. This is Jasher chapter 2. Now, it tells you in Jasher chapter 2 about self being born. All right? Now, brothers and sisters, I'm going to show you something. Let's skip over to verse 15. So we're going to scroll down. Jasher chapter 2, verse 15. And when was Canaan was 70 years old, he begat three sons. He begat three sons and two daughters. See? In the book of Genesis, it just tells you in the book of Genesis chapter 5, it just tells you that Canaan had sons and daughters. Right? Because it says Genesis 5 and 13. Let's go back to Genesis 5 and 13. Right? Genesis 5 and 13. And Canaan lived after he begot Mahalalel 840 years. It says that he begat sons and daughters. So Genesis 5 and 13 tells you that Canaan begat sons and daughters, but it don't go into detail and show you who his sons and daughters are. So the book of Jasher, chapter 2, verse 15, is going into more detail. Jasher 2 and 15. And when Canaan was 70 years old, he begat three sons and two daughters. Now let's focus on these two daughters. Let's focus on these two daughters here. Who are these two daughters? You're going to find out these two daughters was Ada and Zillah. Okay? Going back to Genesis chapter 4. Okay? Genesis chapter 4. And going down, these two daughters of Canaan was actually in Genesis chapter 4 verse 19. Lamech, which was the descendant of that wicked ass bloodline, Cain. Lamech took two wives. Now who were they? Ada and Zillah. Ada and Zillah, okay, in the book of Jasher, chapter 2, verse 15, is the two daughters of who? Canaan. Now, what bloodline did Canaan come from? Okay, shall we show you? Skip over to Genesis chapter 5. The generations of Adam. It went from Adam. It went on down to Seth. It went from Seth. It went down to Enos. It went from Enos. Okay, and it went down to Canaan. Now, all these are the descendants of who? Adam. These were the descendants of Adam. Adam had Seth. Seth was that appointed one. And the Sethites were better yet known as sons of God. And all those came from Seth bloodline was called sons of God. Well, you see right here, who came from Seth bloodline? Canaan. Canaan's two daughters took Lamech, which was the descendant of Cain, that wicked-ass bloodline. Cain had a descendant by the name of Lamech, and Lamech took two wives, the first polygamous in the earth, Ada and Zillah, which was the daughters of who? Which was the daughters of Canaan from that righteous seed. So that's interracial marriage, man. That is a sin according to the Bible. And that's what pissed God off to send the flood upon the earth. It was not that fallen angels came down and started having sex with daughters of man. The fallen angels was the Israelites before they received the name Israel. The sons of God, that chosen bloodline that intermingled with other people when God told them not to do that. So Canaan had two daughters. Let me show you who they are. Verse 16 out of, we're still in the book of Jasher chapter 2, verse 16. And these names are the children of Canaan, the name of the firstborn. It says Mahalalel, the second Enan. It says the third Mered. Okay. It says, now look here. It speaks on the behalf of Canaan. It speaks on the behalf of Canaan having sons. And it speaks on the behalf of Canaan's sons, sisters. It says their sisters were Ada and Zillah. These are the five children of Canaan that were born to him. So Ada and Zillah right here came from who? Canaan, a descendant of Seth. Who married Canaan's daughters, Ada and Zillah? Lamech, a descendant of Cain. Right there. He came from Cain's bloodline and took upon two wives, Ada and Zillah. These wicked ass scholars, devil, this goddamn devil, the white man, tried to be sneaky because he didn't put in the King James Bible who the daughters were, who the daughter's father were. They just said Ada and Zillah, but he did that to keep you from understanding interracial marriage, what was going around in the ancient time, what caused the flood. I hope you see that, brothers and sisters. When you go back into the book of Jasher, you can see that Canaan had two daughters, Ada and Zillah, man, right there. Okay, now let's continue to move on. It says, verse 17, and Lamech, the son of Methuselah, became related to Canaan. So Lamech, the son of Methuselah, Jasher chapter 2, verse 17, Lamech, the son of Methuselah, became related to Canaan. By what? By sex, by marriage. So you had Lamech, which was the son of Methusael. Now Lamech and Methusael are descendants of that wicked ass bloodline of Cain. They became what? They became what? Related. They became related to who? Canaan. Canaan was of self bloodline, the righteous bloodline. So this is cross marriage. This is interracial marriage. That holy seed being mixed with that wicked ass seed, man. Lamech and Methusael, that wicked ass seed, trying to become related to the righteous seed of Canaan, the Sethites, the sons of God, what, by marriage. Because Lamech took Canaan's daughters, Adah and Zillah. See, he took his two daughters for his wives. Adah conceived and bare the son, bare to Lamech's son. And she called his name Jabal. Okay, so you can see right there, man. I'm just bringing this out in Jasher 2 and 17. Lamech, the son of Methusael, and if you don't believe this, the wicked-ass bloodline of Cain, let's go back to Genesis chapter 4, and let's deal with it. Lamech. Said Lamech was the son of Methusael, right? Now look at this, Genesis 4 and 18. It says, and Enoch was born, Arad, and Arad begat Mahajiel, and Mahajiel begat Methusael. Methusael begat Lamech. Book of Jasher 2, chapter 2, verse 17. It says, Lamech, the son of Methusael. See? You can see that, man. Methusael. Methusael begat Lamech. All them came from who? Cain. That wicked-ass bloodline. So this is just interracial marriage that the book of Jasher chapter 2, verse 17, talk about how the Sethites married over into that evil-ass lineage of Cain. That's why they took the book of Jasher out of the Bible, because they didn't want you to know Genesis chapter 6 is actually, that's what led the flood on the earth, interracial marriage. That righteous bloodline want to marry all these other people that was outside their bloodline. They became related, that's marriage, to Canaan. See that? I'm just pointing that out, brothers and sisters, man. I'm just pointing that out. So, you can read the rest on your own, man. I just, like I said, later on, you're going to find out, too, that, brothers and sisters, later on, you're going to find out, too, that Lamech, this same old Lamech right here, that same old Lamech right there, he ends up killing his own father, Cain, the wicked one that killed Abel. Lamech killed Cain, according to the book of Jasher. He slayed Cain. He also killed his son, Tubal Cain. So Lamech killed his father and his son. Who was Lamech's father? Cain, the one that killed his brother Abel. Lamech actually mistakenly shot his father Cain in the side when Cain was approaching him in the field, because Lamech's son Tubal Cain told his father Lamech that an animal was approaching. Well, from far distance, when Lamech got up in age, Lamech had bad sight. He can barely see. So he had to rely on his son Tubal Cain. And Tubal Cain told Lamech that an animal was approaching him from far off. And Lamech didn't know that it was his father Cain coming up. And Tubal Cain, which was Lamech's son, told his father Lamech to shoot at the wild beast. He shot, and he found out that the person that he shot was his father Cain, and Cain died because he was hit with an arrow. So Lamech became very grievous of killing his father Cain, and turned his hand on his own son Tubal Cain. And what did he do? He smacked Tubal Cain. He smited him and killed his own son. So Lamech killed his father Cain and his son, man. Yeah, he did that, and that's why Genesis tell you that, man. That's why Genesis 4. That's why Genesis 4 and 23. It tells you and Lamech said unto his wife, Adah and Zillah, which was those descendants of Seth that he married over in that righteous line, hear my voice, ye wives of Lamech. Hearken unto my speech, for I have slain a man to my wounding and a young man to my hurt. Well, the man that he slain to his wounding was Cain, and that young man to his hurt was his own son, Tubal Cain. So he killed his father and his son. And after he did that, Adah and Zillah was mad as hell with him and didn't want to deal with him no more. They wanted to depart from him because they seen how wicked his ass was, and they didn't want to deal with him no more. Adam and Zillah shouldn't have never dealt with Lamech in the first place, because Adam and Zillah are Canaan daughters, which are is of self bloodline. So they didn't even have no business of cross marrying over into Lamech, the bloodline, because Lamech's bloodline was the wicked ass ones of Cain. You know what I'm saying? And I can show you that, brothers and sisters, dealing with why Adam and Zillah wanted to depart from Lamech after he killed his father and his son. Okay? I can show you that. Let's see. This is Jasher chapter 2, verse 35. Jasher 2 and 35. Watch this. Jasher 2 and 35. And he said to his wives, Adam and Zillah, hear my voice, O wives of Lamech. Attend to my words, for now you have imagined and said that I slew a man with my wounds, that was Cain, and a child with my stripes, that was his own son, Tubal-Cain, for their having done no violence. But surely know that I am old and gray-headed, and that my eyes are heavy through age, and I did this unknowingly. So Lamech killed Cain not intentionally. He was like, his sight was bad. He was up in age. And he just mistakenly, he mistook his father for an animal, and he shot and killed him. But he intentionally killed Tubal-Cain because he felt like Tubal-Cain set him up to kill his own father, Cain, man. All right? He intentionally killed Tubal-Cain, his son. But he told his wife, man, that he didn't mean to kill his father, Cain. Lamech told his wife that. Now, and brothers and sisters, let's see, verse 36. See? And the wives of Lamech listened to him in this manner, and they returned to him with the advice of their father Adam. See? So it's telling you that Lamech's wives listened to him in this manner, and they returned to him with the advice of their father Adam. So Adam and Zillah, which were the descendants of Seth, got advice from their father Adam, because Adam told Adam and Zillah not to have no damn dealings with this wicked ass devil Lamech, because he came from Cain's bloodline. So after they got advice from their father Adam, Adam and Zillah, which was Lamech's two wives, they did what? They bore him no children to him from that time, knowing that God's anger was increasing in those days. Now why? Because interracial marriage was going on. That holy leaning is marrying all these other people that was outside of their bloodline. That's why God's anger was increasing in those days. And you will find out that God's anger led up to Genesis chapter 6, man. Okay? When God repented that he made man, and he said that he was going to send a flood on the earth to drown everybody out. So in those days, against the sons of man, those other nations, which would be modern day Gentiles today, sons of man, to destroy them. See, to destroy them with the waters of the flood. Now, what was this destruction all about? Interracial marriage, man. That righteous line crossing over to these non-righteous people, man. Okay? For their evil doings. What was the evil doings? When self-wives crossed over and married Lamech, man. So, man, this was during the days of the pre-flood. That's what Genesis chapter 6 is all about, man. That's all it's about, people. And it came to pass when man began to multiply on the face of the earth, that daughters were born unto them. Those men was just people in general, everybody in general. When man began to multiply, daughters were born unto them, because daughter was born to all the men on the earth. But the sons of God, those wicked, the sons of God, those righteous ones, saw the daughters of man, saw those other nations' daughters, and they were fair, they were beautiful, and they took them wives of all which they chose. That's interracial marriage. That's all. And it caused, these are not fallen angels, because of the case, why did the Most High Yahweh say, my spirit shall not strive with man, for he's also flesh, yet his days shall be 120 years. There's no stipulation on no angelic being days. The angels don't have stipulation on their timeline. They imminent power. They live forever. These were sons of God, better yet, Israelites before they received the name Israel, that married outside their bloodline. That's all Genesis chapter 6 is talking about, man. All right? There were giants in those days. That means this man of great stature, man of great ability with weaponry, man of fame. That's all. Because basically, like Michael Jordan, let's use him for instance. Michael Jordan was a giant in his field. Michael Jordan was a giant in basketball. He was exceptional. Okay, LeBron James, giant in basketball. Okay, he made other ball players look as amateurs, man, because he was very perfected in his skill. So when you were perfected in your skill and you mastered your skill, you was known as a giant, man. That's all it's talking about. There were giants in those days, man, that were very skillful at weaponry and different things. That's all it's talking about. But let's go back to they took wives. The sons of God took wives of which they chose. This is the same thing. And Ezra 10 and 9. It's the same thing, man. Ezra 10 and 9. During the days of Ezra, man. Okay? During the Persian Mede captivity. It says, then all the men of Judah and Benjamin gathered themselves together into Jerusalem within 3 days, and it was the ninth month, and on the 12th day of the month, and all the people sat in the street of the house of God, trembling because of this matter, and for that, and for the great rain. Now, what matter were they trembling about? Let's skip up ahead. We're going to show you. Let's go back up a couple verses. I'm going to show you. What was this matter? Let's go Ezra 10 and 10. And Ezra the priest stood up and said unto them, ye have transgressed and taken strange wives to increase the trespass of Israel. And Ezra told the Jews that they took strange wives. Did it not say that in Genesis chapter 6? It said the sons of God took the daughters of man who they chose. That's interracial marriage, man. A lot of brothers not going to get it though, man. Now, therefore, make confession unto the Lord Yahweh, your God, of your fathers, and do his pleasure, and separate yourselves from the people of the land and from the strange wives. Okay? That's something they didn't do in Genesis chapter 6. The sons of God didn't separate themselves from these wicked heathen women. And that's what led the flood upon the earth, man, to kill every human upon the earth and spare 8 people. And then you wonder why 8 people survived. Because the rest of the sons of God had went off into wickedness by sleeping with other nations that was outside of their righteous bloodline. Okay. Israel's 9 and 1. Now when these things were done, the princes came to me, saying, the people of Israel and the priests and the Levites have not separated themselves from the people of the lands, doing according to the abominations, even of the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Perizzites, the Jebusites, the Ammonites, Moabites, the Egyptians, and Amorites. And that actually say Edomites too. That actually says Edomites. When you look in the Apocrypha, because it's a precept to Israel 9 and 1. And all these heathen nations that's being mentioned in Ezra's 9 and 1, Ezra 9 and 1, King James Bible, that includes the nation of the Edomites, man. And I'm going to show you that. They just didn't put Edom right there. The white man, slick ass, he didn't put himself, his nation of people right there. Okay, we're going to show you that. Now I'm going to show you the precept to Ezra's in the Apocrypha, chapter 8, verse 68, and show you the same precept because Ezra and Ezra is the same person. Okay, he's a Jew from the tribe of Judah. But I'm going to show you the precept to Ezra 9 and 1 in the Apocrypha to let you see that all these nations that the Israelites was marrying, okay, all these heathens, these Gentiles, Canaanite Africans, Africans, Hittites, Perizzite Africans, Jebusite Africans, Ammonite Japanese, Moabite Chinese, Egyptian Africans, Amorite Africans, and it also said Edomites, and I'm going to show you that. Let's go into the Apocrypha, 1 Ezra 8:68. Brothers and sisters, Ezra in the King James 9:1. I'm going to show you the precept in Ezra's. As you can see, I'm going to show you the precept in Ezra's in the Apocryphal books that was taken out the Bible by the Roman Catholic Protestants. I'm going to show you that same precept. Watch this. This is the King James Version. Okay. And it says, this is 1 Ezra chapter 8, verse 68. I want y'all to see where I'm at in the Apocryphal books. It says, moreover, they that were come out of captivity offered sacrifice unto the Lord Yahweh, their power of Israel. Even 12 bullocks for all Israel, 416 rams, 312 lambs, goats for a peace offering, 12. All of them a sacrifice to the Lord. And they delivered the king's commandment unto the king's stewards and to the governors of Caesarea and Phoenix. And they honored the people in the temple. Now, when these things were done, the rulers came unto me and said, the nation of Israel, the prince, the priests, the Levites, have not put away from them strange people of the land. Now, did not the same thing say that in Ezra 9:1? See, it said the people of Israel and the priests and the Levites have not separated themselves of the people of the land. They say the same thing. Okay, the nation, this is Ezra, 1 Ezra 8:68 verse. The nation of Israel, the princes, the priests, and Levites have not put away themselves strange people of the land. Nor the pollution of the Gentiles. Let's see who the Gentiles are. Canaanites, Hittites, Pharisees, Jebusites, Moabites, Gypsies. It says, and Edomites. The so-called white man, these crackers. And Edomites. How come he didn't put that in the King James in Ezra 9:1? You don't see it there. Because he don't want you to know he's goddamn devil. And that we don't supposed to be taking this nasty ass woman. Alright? This is 1 Ezra chapter 8, verse 70. Okay? For both, they and their sons have married with the daughters, and the holy seed is mixed with strange people. That's what I wanted to bring out, brothers and sisters. It says, the holy seed is mixed with strange people of the land. And from the beginning of this matter, the rulers and the great man have been partakers of iniquity. So it says that this happened from what? This happened from the beginning. The holy seed, this is 1 Ezra chapter 8, verse 7 in the Apocrypha. The holy seed is mixed with strange people. Gentile, heathen woman of the land. And from the beginning, when was that? That happened in Genesis. From the beginning of this matter, the rulers and the great man have been partakers of iniquities. And that's what caused the flood in Genesis chapter 6. As soon as I had heard these things, I rent my clothes and the holy garment and pulled off the hair from off my head and beard and sat me down. Sad and very heavy. Because Ezra was pissed off at these Jews sleeping around with these nasty ass heathen women, man. So I hope that was edifying to you. But if you still want to insist on Genesis chapter 6, it's talking about fallen angels. It's not talking about fallen angels, brothers and sisters. If you still insist on Genesis chapter 6 talking about fallen angels, I can give you a cold cut to that. And this lesson will be over with. It's not talking about fallen angels at all. This is Hebrews 1:4. I'm going to show you something, because he never called the angels his sons. So if you're saying that sons of God is in Genesis chapter 6, he never called the angels his son at any time. These are not the angels. Angels are not called sons of God. Okay? He never called angels sons of God. How we know that? This is Hebrews 1. And now we'll start with verse 4. Being so much better than the angels, he's talking about Yahweh Shai, Jesus Christ, who they call today, as he had by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. It tells you, it says, Hebrews 1 and 5, for unto which of the angels, for which of the angels said he at any time, thou art my son. So, for unto which of the angels he said at any time, thou art my son. He never said to the angels at any time, thou art my son. So the sons of God in Genesis chapter 6 are not the angels. I'm telling you who it is. It's that righteous seed, self-lineage, that crossed over and started marrying outside of his holy seed. This day I have begotten thee, and again I will be to him a father, and he shall be to my son. So he said, I never told angels at any time that thou art my son. I never told angels I have begotten thee. I never told angels that I would be to them a father, and they should be to me a son. He only told Yahweh Shai that, who the world calls Jesus Christ. So man, sons of God are not fallen angels. They are the S.F.I.A. They are that righteous lineage that came from self-bloodline. And back then, they was known as sons of God. And later on to come, they will be known as Israelites. That's all it's talking about. Hope you was edified once again. It's your boy Judah Israel on the behalf of Solid Foundation, Israelite Academy. Brothers and sisters, I hope this was edifying to you. I know it was a long lesson, but share the truth and help your brothers and sisters, man. Once again, Shalom.